Good morning.
Welcome to the Green Valley Parkinson's Support Group exercise class. Oh, that's not what you thought this was? No, I'm just kidding. And if it's your first time joining us online on YouTube, welcome. You're going to need a chair without arms and a pair of light hand weights and a tennis ball, slightly larger ball, about 10, 11 inches, and some water. It's summer, stay hydrated. Class is about 45 minutes long. We start in a chair, we stand for a while, we come back into the chair for cool down. But before we start, make sure that you're seated forward in the chair and that you have some room beside you. You're not gonna hit the person you're going home with.
All right?
I think we should start with
cookies.
Yay!
There's one in every crowd.
It'll keep us.
So, sit forward. Sit forward in the chair. This is our best behavior, by the way. You're joining us online from I don't know where. Your feet flat on the floor. Sit tall in the chair. Take a deep breath through the nose. Laugh it out. Again. One more. That's a good way to start. All right. Some head nods, drop the chin to the chest and raise the head. Again, looking down and looking up, stretching. Turning to look over your shoulder. Both sides. And again, the chin to the chest for a head roll. The other way. Looking down and again to the front. Roll the shoulders, big circles. And then change direction. Good morning, Dennis.
Hi.
And shoulder shrugs up and down. Up, one more. Good job. The arms extended. Shoulders now relax. Move your fingers. And then stretch them out, tapping each finger to the thumb. Scratch something. Make a tight fist. Relax the hand. Extend the fingers. Circle
one, two, three, four.
Five, and then
five,
the other way.
Four, three, two, one.
Big circles. Yeah. And then change direction. Rotating the shoulder. Keeping those arms reaching overhead. It's one and two. Join
and
us counting.
Three and
four. And
one
more.
Five. And
let them come to the side again, flexing the hand. Bring it in, push
one,
out.
Two, three, four, five.
They come down, resting one with a bent elbow for a side stretch. And then to the other side. Good. Cross the arms. Twist the upper torso, looking at something behind you. And then to the other side. Facing front again, those hands rest here, shifting your weight to one side, and then the opposite hip is up. One,
and
you got it.
Two,
and they are
three, three,
and
four,
and one more.
Five, and
Donna, take it into a march.
Oh, Donna.
Drop to the outside of the chair for some heel taps out and in with a flexed foot.
Two,
focusing
and
forward.
Three and
four
and
one more.
Five,
and again, they come back to this position where we're going to rock forward and back, waking up our ankles. Good. And then one up, one down. And then here, straight out with one. Lift it, draw a circle a few.
Two, three, four,
Five, change direction.
Four, three, two, one.
And there, the same thing on the other side. It's one,
two, three,
four,
five,
four,
three,
two, one. And we're here. Still have that room between you and the back of the chair, then you're in the right place. Reach down and grab the weights. We always want to sit forward in the chair. Well, there are a few exceptions. But right now, toward the front, practicing good posture. The fingers are wrapped and the elbows tucked. Just start with that bicep curl. Raise it.
One.
Box it.
Two.
Three. Count with us.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Excellent.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten. And they rest briefly as we stretch. Right, Mary? Stretch it out a little bit. And again, sit tall, the focus is forward, raise it up, it's
one, two,
I saw that,
three, four,
good,
five, six,
seven,
eight, nine, ten,
where they go to the side, to the outside of the chair legs, rotating arms and shoulders forward, and then pull them back, pinching the shoulder blades together. Again to this neutral position. Lift one up, tuck the elbow, looking forward. It's a side stretch. Where is the floor? Okay. And then to the other side, tucking that elbow to the back. Good, nice. And here. We're going to place them both on the floor underneath the chair briefly as we bring our feet together. A little adjustment maybe in the chair. Try to keep that space between you and the back. And the arms are crossed, legs straight out, and the feet are up. And it's flex
one,
and point.
Two, three, four.
Count with me.
Five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten. Now, feet are flexed, the heels are glued together, and the toes are out one, and in for five.
Two, three,
four. Reverse
five,
it. Heels
one,
out.
Two, three, four, five.
Blast off. All right, and here. Separate the feet, uncross those arms. We're back to a starting position. Straight out. Shoulders over hips, yes. And the hands are here. Sliding those hands down. I was gonna say the seam of your pants, but most of you have shorts on. Drop into the stretch and breathe. And come up, nice. Bringing that back to a starting position. Trying to keep the foot on the floor, maintaining a straight leg, drop into the stretch. Nice. And come up. Again with that first leg, and the arms are out. An open hand, fingers spread apart. As you twist the upper torso, opposite hand reaches for that foot. The focus is on the foot as this arm is reaching up to change a light bulb in the ceiling. Yeah. And come up. And then other, same arm as leg, nice bob, and come up. The arms drop, the other leg comes out. Again, posture, as you twist, reach for it, breathe into that stretch, nice. And come up, and again, same arm as leg, breathe, and there, nice. And the arms return to that starting position, one weight, one hand. The fingers are wrapped in the same grip, brought to the shoulder and straight up. And sometimes, you know, this is too high, so we want to get it even. That drops to the back. It's supported by the other hand if needed, and it's
one,
two, or not.
Three.
Yes.
Four.
Five.
Looking forward.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten. And take a little break, stretch and breathe, keep it in that hand. And again, sit tall, straight up, drop it to the back and raise it.
One, two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven, use it.
Eight,
nine,
ten.
Yeah, be careful which weight you pull out of that closet. It's in the other hand. And it's here, overhead, and hovering over the head, supported if it needs it. It's gonna come straight
one,
up and down.
two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
excellent,
seven,
eight,
do you feel that?
Nine,
yes,
ten. Everyone's like, what is wrong with her? Of course we feel that. I feel it. All right, straight up, it drops over.
One,
sorry,
two,
three,
four,
five,
good,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten,
and down. And down on the floor it goes. Out to the edge a bit more, maybe, and a nice wide position to stretch that inner thigh and the hip area, and the arms are out. Placing a hand on the inside, same side, inside of the knee, straight up. You're gonna twist, you're gonna reach for the ceiling. Look up at your hands, as this one is trying to find the ankle, maybe even the floor, and then returning to that position, good job. And then it's here, a twist and a reach, spreading the fingers, trying to reach for the ceiling, nice. And there, the arms drop down, pivot on the heel, then the ball of the foot, we close everything in. Feet are together, and the knees may be touching across the arms. The weight transfers forward, it's a flat back and the knees open. And that weight is, on the outside of the ankle, good. And come up. And again, transfer the weight and stretch. Beautiful. And there. So separate the feet, uncross arms. We're back kind of into that seat a little bit more. One weight, both hands, working shoulders. So we hold it horizontally, the knuckles on top, and again, grow a couple of inches out of the rib cage. And this is gonna be about chest height and down.
Two,
not too high.
Three,
four,
excellent.
Five,
look at all the red.
Six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten.
Great job. Take a little break, stretch, breathe, whatever. And again, they're wrapped. Looking forward, raise it,
one,
and down.
Two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
and it's
ten.
And now we've done three major muscles in the upper body, and we're gonna put those on the floor. And we're gonna do some flutters and some scissors with our legs. So find that place in the chair, perhaps not leaning against the back, but perhaps a little deeper into the chair. The arms are crossed, the legs are out. Let's start with some flutters. So it's out and cross, two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
good,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten. Let's do some flutters. Two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten. And they come down. Separate the feet. Bring it back into this position. The arms are dropped to the side, and that's why we want chairs without armrests, because we sometimes use this. We're here, sliding one forward, and then at the last minute, see if you can pop that toe up with a straight leg, forcing it to the floor. And then again here, and one more, bringing it in straight out at the last minute. You can flex it, and yes, good job. Yeah, and there, we come back to this position. We're gonna shift some of this weight to one hip, lifting the other knee up. So flex foot, and then extend and point and flex.
Two,
three,
four,
five,
good job.
Six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten.
Put it down and the weight to the other side. It's up,
one,
out.
Two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten.
And again there. I mentioned a tennis ball earlier. Pardon me. Do we all have a tennis ball? Yeah? Okay. We're going to work later on to warm up our hands and feet, but right now we're going to work with opposite hand and foot. So we're going to come forward in the chair, and this takes some practice, and we've been doing it in class for a while. So I'm right-handed. We're going to pretend to throw forward. I'm going to throw with my right and lift my left knee. I transfer it to the other side, throwing that way. And now it's to the side, always a transfer. Look where you're going to throw. And then look where you're going to throw. Excellent. And then open and look up. Transfer, close, and look down. I wish it were that slow, but it's not. So stay with us and ready? Go.
One.
Two.
To the side.
Three. Four.
Open.
Five.
Close it.
Six.
One more time. Separate the feet. Are you ready? Ready. Okay. One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Excellent job. We're going to use it again. So if you're in class, we just squeeze it, put it back into that position. Straight out, one over the other. And this would be good if we could just sit like this. But no, just sit tall. Grow 2-3 inches taller out of the rib cage. The arms extend, the hands together for some toe touches. Reach forward,
one.
And come up,
two.
One more,
three.
And now put the other one on top. Let's go overhead this time, reaching up and over.
One.
Two. Stretch it.
Three.
Yes. And then an open stance again. Stretching out, trying to keep the feet in line with your knees. And the arms are out, fingers spread apart. The heel taps to the back. It's one.
Two.
Working that way slightly.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Yes.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
And the arms drop. Pivot on the heel, the ball of the foot. We come back to a starting position. And the arms are out for some toe touches in the air. It's one.
And
two.
And
three.
And
four,
and
five,
and
six,
and
seven,
and
yes,
eight,
and
nine,
and
ten.
And who speeds that up? Your feet together, knees touching, and perhaps a little bit more space between you and the back of the chair. Hold on. And lean back as we bring the knees to the chest. It's up.
One,
two,
good.
Three,
four,
five,
yes.
Six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten. Separate. Have water throughout the class. I know I don't, but please do. So your feet now apart for balance. Space between you and the back, and the hands are here. We're going to do a chair lift. This is upper body strength. The feet are just there for balance. And so transfer your weight. Lift yourself off the seat if you can for 10.
Two.
Good.
Three.
Nice.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
And down. All right. Take a deep breath. Grab those weights, please. Placing them close to the knee, and you still have that space between you and the back of the chair. It's an open hand resting on the knee. Lift one, extend it out, bend it, put it back on the floor, transfer the weight to the other side. Good. And down.
Two.
Out,
in,
down. Lift it high, extend it.
In, down.
Three.
Stretched.
Out, in,
down.
Up.
Out,
in,
down.
Four.
Out, in, down. Up,
out,
in.
One more.
Five,
on each side.
Out, in, down.
And lift,
stretch. Out, in, down.
And straight out. Sitting forward in the chair for a leg lift. It's a relaxed foot. And it's up.
One, two,
Three.
Good.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
Flex it up, down.
Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight.
Nine. Ten. And put it down. I'm trying to rest my voice. I think I talk a lot. All right. No comments. Stretch it out. Lift it up.
One,
it's one.
Two. Three. Four.
Five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten.
Toes up.
One,
it's a flex
two,
foot.
Three, four, five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten.
Beautiful. And there. We're done with weights. So we're going to put them on the floor. And once again, we grab the tennis ball. Here. Good posture. Some space between you and the back. Roll that between your hands and wake them up. Balance begins at the bottom of your feet, so if you have an opportunity to take your shoes off and have bare feet or stocking feet, you'll feel this more. So, stretched between the fingers, good posture in the chair. Takes all the fun out of it, doesn't she? And then a soft fist where the ball will rest. Extend the arm out from the shoulder, bring it close to you, and again, extend it out, bring it close, halfway out, transferring it to that hand. And again, stretch it. Beautiful job. All right. And on the floor, under one foot, whether it's got a shoe, a sock, or nothing at all, push down on that ball and then roll your foot across, stimulating the bottom of your feet where all the nerves are. Yeah. Nancy, you probably can't feel it with those thick shoes, but a little bit, yeah? Good. All right, so underneath the other foot, push down. Cute socks, Raquel, very cute. All right. Everyone should have a tennis ball at home. All right, we grab it. We're going to squeeze it back into the chair. We're going to scoot ourselves back into the chair. Where the back meets the seat, and our feet still wide, but they're slightly behind the knees, engaging those muscles, pushing into the spine and into the chair. Arch your back. Press into it, tucking the tailbone. Good. But again, trying to keep those shoulder blades against the back of the chair. Yeah. All right. Looking forward, they extend and lift. And again, it's
one,
a circle.
Two, three, four.
Reverse it.
Five,
four,
three,
two,
one.
And they come back to the floor. Pull them behind the knees. Pull yourself off that chair, shifting your weight. Rock, walk, toward the very edge of that seat with the arms extended, palms up, and the shoulders relaxed. Lean back, don't touch. And come up. Perfect. Lean back.
Two.
And sit tall.
Three.
Y'all breathing?
Yes.
Four.
Okay, good. Anita says yes. Go back and hold. One,
two,
three,
four,
five.
And come up. Placing the hands on your thighs, a flat back transfers weight over them, over the knees. Looking down, lift a heel up. Lift the other heel up. Drop the first, the second. It's up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, down. One more.
Up, down.
Just heels
up
and down. Getting some flexibility. Good. So we are in a position called
sit to stand.
Nose over toes
for a sit to stand. Right. So the weight is transferred to the ball of the foot and we come up. Beautiful. And then come into the chair, bending the knees. The weight is in the heel. Nice, Barb. And back to shoulders over hips. The weight is forward. I don't see any plopping. Nice job.
Three.
Three. She's like, we're not doing any more than we have to.
Two more.
Four. All the way up. Nice. Control it, control it. Good. Last one. Forward and up. And back into the chair. And back to a starting position with our fingers apart, resting them on the neck, the elbows stretched to the side. Warm up for a seated crunch. You want to get a twist. And then twist, lift the knee to the opposite elbow and up.
Two, three, four, and one more.
Five. Great job. All right, the large ball. You better put your sunglasses on.
Yeah, those shine.
I'll put it right there.
Sitting forward in the chair, a little space between you and the back. Good posture. Help with the palm of the hand. It's on the chest and the elbows are dropped. Find something to look at in front of you. Eye level, extending those arms, transferring the weight again over your thighs and knees. It's a flat back, reaching out as far as you can and hold. Two, three, four, five. Come up and then raise those arms overhead and lean back slightly and hold.
Two, three, four, five.
Again here, drop it, tracking the ball as you twist the torso. That back arm pulls and hold. Two, three, four, five. And to the other side as far as you can go and hold.
Two, three, four, five.
Beautiful. And then it's on the inside thigh. We're out to the edge, sitting maybe like halfway toward the front of my chair. Yeah, and our feet come together. One of the few times you want to bring your feet close together and then squeeze that.
Two, three, four, five, six,
hard.
Seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Relax, hold the ball, the feet again apart. We're gonna get out of the chair. No longer will we use this. So make sure it's somewhere that won't trip you. That nose over toes, come up. Don't be in a rush. Maybe you feel a little dizzy.
We have to rush.
Acclimate to the standing position. To the back of the chair, about arm's distance away, the fingers rest softly on the chair back. Or to the side, but your focus is important. So you want to look out and lift it up and down. The heels up and down.
Three, good. Four.
Thank you, Steve.
Five, six, seven.
Excellent. Eight, nine, ten. The fingers again rest here, at least mine do. And the weight is in the heel. Toes up.
Two.
I see some of you with
arms. Three, four, five, six.
Excellent. Seven, eight, nine, ten. And shake it out. I'm going to turn mine slightly so the camera can see. And we're going to do some leg lifts. So who's behind you matters. I think we've got Barb. You okay back there? Feet apart, fingers here, but the weight is now just on one leg and it's a straight leg, soft knee, while this one extends to the back. Straight leg, lift it up. It's one, two,
three, four, five, six,
yeah, seven, eight, nine. Now keep it to the back, bending the standing knee, sitting into that stretch. Yes. And then come up, the laundry's done. So bring this forward, transferring the weight. The other leg extends and it's up.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Bend and stretch it out. Perfect. And again, we come to this position where we're gonna do kicks. five on each side. So it's one
and
two
and
kick it.
Three
and
four
and one more.
Five.
Super job. We're going to come to the side of the chair. Our body lined up with the frame, but the weight is on the inside leg, and the hand is there for security. Find something in front of you to look at, eye level, as you extend this forward, barely touching the floor with the ball of the foot. Lift it up for 10. It's
one,
two,
good.
Three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight.
Excellent.
Nine,
and then we bend it, and it's up about hip height.
Two.
Perfect.
Three.
Four.
Five.
And we come to rest. We're going to do a little.
Is it too loud? Is it too loud? Okay.
We're going to do a little balance. And today, it's with movement. So to the side of that chair, we stand. And it looks like this. You can either use both or just the outside arm while this one holds or rests softly. The motion is one or one, two or two, three or three. Notice it comes back to the, and it's really easy to want to come back to this, but that is not a very good place to be. So we always want to keep it wide, shoulders, hips, and heels. So let's start with just that outside arm. As the weight is placed on the inside leg, the hand here, focus not on the floor, but on something in front of you. As you extend the outside arm and the outside leg front, sweep it to the side, looking forward the whole time.
Three.
To back, and it comes down.
Four.
Excellent. One more time. One. If you want to.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three. And it comes back to that position. Good. Let's go to the other side. This is a hard one.
Yes.
Very. So again, line yourself up with the frame. Bring the weight on the inside leg, the hand here. And it's outside arm, sweep it to the side, raise it overhead and extend it behind you, and bring it down. One more time. One,
two,
excellent.
Three,
four. All right. We have space back there. We have a couple of minutes of cardio. So remember that we need floor space, so we want to keep it safe and don't put ourselves in harm's way. And it's summertime, so we've got some summer music. Guess what it is? It involves water. And maybe
more.
Go, go, go. Yeah. All right. Cardio has never been a large part of any of my classes, but it's a very important part of any good exercise program to incorporate some of that and to incorporate it into everyday life. You know, you can chase each other around the house.
Naked.
I'm sorry. All right. Reach down and grab your weights.
There's a bunch of people following her.
Come forward in the chair. The fingers are wrapped and the arms extended. Wow. All right, forward, it's a flat back. Drop the weight between the feet and extend it overhead.
Two, up, three, up, four,
raise up high.
Five, more, six, up, seven, up, eight, up, nine, up, ten, up.
I like it when I hear Mary go, or was that Larry? Make sure you are forward in the chair, your feet flat on the floor. Take a deep breath through the nose. And out slowly through the mouth. Again. Let it out. One more.
And the outlaws I see in my dream.
Bow the head. Look up. Stretch. Again, look down and to the front. Listen. Drop the chin, sit tall in the chair as you circle the head. And then let's go the other way. Chin to the chest, sit tall and raise it up, relaxing the jaw and center the shoulders forward and up. Pull them back, down, big circles, and then change direction. Stretched out as you were before. Good. And then wanders.
The sage and cactus of blue.
Give yourselves a big hug. Tuck the chin. And then open. Place the other arm on top. Again, give yourself a big squeeze. Our face and our voice say A-E-I-O-U. Join us.
A-E-I-O-U.
One more time.
A-E-I-O-U.
Thank you for being here. Have a wonderful, very safe, very fun. fun 4th of July. Remember what it's all about. And we'll be back here again on Friday. Yeah, because tomorrow's the holiday. In the meantime, go out and make it a great day. Be happy and healthy and safe. And above all, be kind to each other. And we'll see you soon.
Time for cookies.
Oh.